Om Shanti. Today is your 86th day of your beautiful meditative Vardhan, a Vardhan in which God teaches us the biggest and the simplest and the most powerful teaching of Bhagavad Gita, which we have learned. We have read it, but do we understand it in details? That's what God comes down on earth to explain to us right now in this Kali Yuga. He has already descended and he tells us that for us to be liberated, we have to think two things very carefully. The last chapter of Bhagavad Gita is about becoming totally detached and to be in constant, continuous remembrance of God, detached from our body, detached from relationships, detached from things around us. But detachment doesn't mean that we don't take care of those things, but we take care of them as we are just instruments for the body, given by God, for the relationships, given by God, for the things around us, given by God. So we are just trustees of that. So let's understand what Baba has to say today. In this Vardhan, Baba says, may you remain beyond a detached observer. May you remain beyond a detached observer and become free from all attractions by having the awareness of the two words. What are those? Great, in bracket Mahan, and guest, in bracket Mehman. I'm a guest on this earth. So let's understand what is the meaning of this in details, in depth. In order to make your stage that of being beyond, we are all looking for liberation, but what is the deep knowledge of liberation? In order to make your stage that of being beyond a detached observer, pay attention to two things, Baba says, God says. First, I the soul am a great soul. First of all, I have to remember that I am the child of the supreme incorporeal Godfather, who doesn't take birth through any human mother or father, who doesn't have any physical parents and can never be born as a small child, as has been mentioned in many other Shastras. They have shown human souls or divine deities as God, a big mistake which has been done. So God, the incorporeal father, who doesn't have parents, who doesn't have his hands, legs, eyes, mouth like you and me, who doesn't eat, sleep, or need any form of clothing or protection from any parents or anything, is supreme Godfather Shiva, who doesn't have a body of his own. So he's the Jyotirlingam, or the symbol of light. That's the meaning of it. So God says that I, the soul, am a great soul because I am also the child of Supreme Godfather. I was liberated once when I was up in Paramdham or Supreme Abode. But now I have come down, I have gotten into different bodies and I have got attached to these bodies. So Baba says, I, the soul, am a great soul. First, remember that. Second, I, the soul, am a guest in this old world, because Kali Yuga is known as the old world. And this old body, the old body is a body which is full of diseases, or is an old body. So this body which we think is so beautiful and we try to compare ourselves and looking in the mirror, Baba says, the golden age or the Satyug or the Swarnim Yug body was so beautiful of deities that your body is nothing in comparison to them. So don't have the ego of being beautiful or smart or tall or thin or fair or whatsoever it is you are so proud about, because this body is an old body. And that's what God tries to come and teach us, which we are attached to this body. The comments which people make on this body about your handsomeness or beautifulness is all false as compared to the world which he had created and sent us into, as in heaven on earth a couple of thousand of years back. So then Baba says, I am the soul, I am a guest in this old world and this old body. By your having this awareness, what happens? All the weaknesses and attractions of attachment will easily and automatically finish. If I'm a powerful soul, then I won't be thinking about my worldly gains and being sad about it. So we say whether we are victorious or we are defeated, whether we are in profit or we are in loss, whether somebody gives us any compliment or disdains or puts us down, we are all in a constant stage in the mind. That's what's the learning of Bhagavad Gita. Ninda, stuti, labhani, man, apman. You are constant in that stage. So Baba says, by your having this awareness, all the weaknesses and attractions of attachment to this body and worldly things around us, because we are just as guests in the body also and in this world also. Everything which you see, my eyes are seeing, I the soul through these eyes, I am seeing this mobile phone, I am seeing this library, all the books, in this house I am sitting right now, within this body and in this world. But I am detached from all these things. If anything happens to them, I am not attached. I don't blame anybody. I am not feeling up or down. My mood doesn't swing if something happens. I am detached observer. But I am also taking care of all these things because these are gifts of God. But I don't come into the feeling of why, when, what, how, where, who did it. No. Or Baba says, by your having this awareness, all the weaknesses and attractions of attachment will easily automatically finish. By understanding yourself to be great, the ordinary actions you perform, everyday actions, eating, sleeping, that's it. But we are doing seva. That means I think for the world, think for the souls of the world. I meditate for them. I get up in the morning, no laziness, nothing. So I become great soul over a period of time by doing all those good things and powerful things as per the guidance or Srimad of God the Father. So the ordinary thoughts you have under the influence of your sanskars, the old sanskars could be anger, ego, jealousy, laziness, or could be postponement of things, of the good things which you want to do in your life, all those things. By moving along while considering yourself to be great and as a guest, you will become worthy of being praised. Praised by whom? First God himself, that you are following my directions and you're becoming worthy of praise. And plus, because of our strength and power, when we help a lot of souls, automatically God gets praised via us, through us. It's not our praise because we were impure and God has given us this knowledge and made us pure, because of which other souls, they praise us. But that praise actually is the praise of who? The giver, God the Father. So I leave you with this beautiful meditative blessing. Understand that I am a great soul and I am a guest soul. And this will help you to become powerful in your mind. And think of everybody also as a guest soul and also a great soul. And look at only the goodness in them. With this, I leave you. Have a blessed day. Om Shanti.